Hello, back again with a tag video I have not been tagged for, but you know, I don't really care. So this time it's the 13 personal questions. Number one, what do you order at Starbucks? We don't have Starbucks in Norway, but if I were to go into a Starbucks, I would probably get something pretty basic, like black coffee. Nothing fancy. Number two, what's one thing in your closet you cannot live without? Wow. Well, I have a few prized possessions in my closet, like nice vintage items and stuff like that, but I guess the one type of thing I couldn't live without would have to be jeans. Because I wear jeans everywhere, every day for work, pretty much, and yeah, probably jeans. A good pair of jeans. Number three, what's one thing that most people probably wouldn't know about you? Not many people right off the bat would know that I'm allergic to certain types of foods, maybe. Name one thing that you want to do before you die. Well, there's probably a lot of things, but I would like to visit friends. Friends from the US. I'd like to go back to Japan for holidays. There's quite a few things, really. Just the usual, like skydive, bungee jump, travel a lot, ride an elephant, usual crap. Number five, what's one food that you cannot live without? Does water count? I'm gonna have to say, well, I guess I could live without it if I had to, but the type of food I probably eat the most out of everything would have to be like plain bread with cheese on it. Oh, here's a good one. Number six. What quote or phrase do you live your life by? Actually, there is one. It's in Latin, and it's Carpe Diem and Memento Mori. And to me, you probably heard Carpe Diem before. It means seize the day in English. And that's all well and good, I think. But I also add the memento mori to it because, to me at least, it kind of means remember your mortality or remember death, in a way. So those two put together to me would mean go out, have fun, seize the day, but and or live as though it's your last day alive. But with the memento mori attached, it would be all that. And don't be stupid. Remember that some things may be lethal. Do not make this your last day on the planet, kind of thing. And that's the motto I've had for like 10 years now, I think. It also turned out in my tattoo. Let's see if I can move up so you can see. I love it. It's a cherry blossom. And I wanted to get the quote on my wrists, like across here, and then on the other side I would have the other one and have both. So like this one would be Carpe Diem, Memento Mori, and then the other one would be mento mori, carpe diem, so kind of just did like this. It would be both of them. But I figured that if I tattooed something like that on myself, and in 20 years' time, if I didn't feel the same way, or didn't think about the quote anymore, or didn't follow it the same way I do now, it would be kind of silly to have the words on my body. And this flower, this cherry blossom, was the symbol of the old samurai code called the Bushido in Japan, when Japan still was a feudal empire. And in Japan, the cherry blossom represents life because it's a very tiny light flower and it blooms very shortly. Like, it blooms and then it takes almost nothing for it to kind of blow away. So as a metaphor for life, it's pretty nice. And it was also the symbol from the Bushido code because of that. And also, the Bushido code stated that today is a good day to die, meaning that in battle, or for a samurai, in battle would be the most honorable way to die. Of course, trying not to die, obviously. But yeah, so that's why I chose the flower instead, because then if in 20 years I don't feel the same way about the quote or the meaning behind the flower, I still have a nice pretty flower, and that wouldn't really be a big deal, because it's like, it's maybe 2 inches almost, like from tip to tip. So it's not that big, and it's easy to hide. I mean, number 7. What do you like and dislike about the YouTube community? I don't know. I mean, I like it, of course. I really like the fact that I can go on YouTube and like search for something, rather review, and get an honest opinion for the most part on something. And I haven't really found anything to dislike yet, but then I haven't really been an active member for that long either. So as of right now, I found stuff I like and haven't really found anything to dislike. Number 8. What's your number one most listened to song on iTunes? Oh wow, that varies a lot. I don't even know what it would be now. Probably something from Lady Gaga. I don't know. What kind of style would you define yourself as having? That's an easy one. I have no style. I have a mix of all sorts of styles. And for work, I tend to wear jeans and a t-shirt, or jeans and like a long sleeve t-shirt. Something very basic, very plain. Let's see, number 10. Favorite number? 8. Easy. 8. 2 hobbies. Wow. I write a lot. Both like... Oh, hello. Come here. Little kitty. My cat just walked in. Look at him. Isn't he cute? Yes. Yes. There you go. He has his little spot here in the office. Let's see, yes, 2 hobbies. I write a lot. And not only just like blogs and stuff, I try to write books. And it takes a long time. And it really depends on the motivation. But I do try. So writing is a big hobby of mine, and I do a bit of photography every now and then. I won't say I'm that awesome at it or anything, but I like doing it. I think it's fun. And I do some web design, and I listen to a lot of music. I am in front of the computer a lot, so I guess I could say the internet is my hobby. But yeah, I would probably say writing and photography would be the two bigger ones.
Eves.
This is going to sound kind of, I don't know, snobbish maybe, but I was taught English in school, and we were taught how to actually write English in school, like correct English, spelling and all that stuff. And I think one of my bigger pet peeves is when people, especially native English speakers, who cannot for the life of them type even remotely correctly. For grammar, more or less, like punctuation and things like that, but also spelling in general. Because I do spend a lot of time online, I do talk to a lot of people online, and like chat rooms and MSN and things like that. And for me, because I don't speak English as a first language, it's difficult to understand sometimes if they type something that's supposedly to them sounds or looks more like it sounds, but to me it's just like, but that's, what is that? So that would be one of them. And the other one is my name. Again, native English speaking people, trying to pronounce my name, my actual name, is sometimes a little annoying. because, see, the story is I've lived a year in the US when I was like 12. My dad had a sabbatical at one of the universities over there, and we just went. And I went to public school in the US, and every single person over there would mispronounce my name. Now, I got used to it, but if I had the opportunity to correct them, I do. So, my name is spelled S-T-I-N-E. And most people will try to say something along the lines of Stein, probably due to the author R.L. Stein, or Stein, who wrote those, I think it's Goosebumps books or something, I don't know. But Stein isn't how it's pronounced at all. And then, failing that, they would try with Stina, which is also the wrong name, because then it would have the A at the end of the name. So, with correct pronunciation, it sounds like Stine. Yeah. Stine. Pretty easy, really, when you think about it, but it looks different than anything in English. So I understand why they would kind of struggle with it. And they don't really think about it, but they, English speakers do have the sounds required to say my name. But yeah, two pet peeves would be bad grammar and spelling, and also really screwing up my name. And then the last question is guilty pleasure. The few people out there who know me personally, they know that I listen to a lot of metal, like black metal, death metal. I'm that kind of girl. So, I would have to say pop music and or anything remotely girly like that. Like, I can look like a complete metalhead, like all black, black hair, black makeup, black long leather coat, walking down the street listening to Britney Spears, no problem. Because she actually has some pretty good stuff. Who knew? So I guess my guilty pleasure would have to be something like that. So that was my 13 personal tidbits.